was a bit quiet for a while. When he came back, he obviously didn't just deal with the travelling, handle the travelling very well. But sort of the last 2 or 3 weeks, he's really been back to himself, and he's done a couple of real nice bits of work. So he's sort of back where he was before Ascot. He's obviously facing and sort of likes to beat the bank, and that obviously he did beat the bank in the Queen Anne. But we've got to carry a penalty, and listen, he's obviously got a bit of work to do with them, but. He's in great form, and on his A day, if he turns up, you know, and things work out for him, he's obviously good enough to beat them. I sat in him on Saturday, and he did a really nice piece of work. And like I say, he's definitely sort of back to close to what he was before the Queen Anne. Massive key is straight track for him, because he likes to sort of take his time and have a bit of space out the back. Ascot obviously suits him massively, because it suits hold up horses, you know, and it's a stiff straight mile there, and he sort of, it likes it there. But yeah, he won a big sales race at Newmarket, so there's nothing to say. Generally, he obviously handles the track there as well, and we're pretty hopeful. There probably won't be as many runners as there was in the Queen Anne, so that'll help as well, because we won't have so much ground to make up, you know. Listen, we were going to go straight to Champions Day, I think, but he hasn't had a run in a while, and he's a big stuffy horse, you know, and he's in great forms, and he's got nearly a month after Friday till Champions Day, you know, so it's just a nice stepping stone, and hopefully he can run well, and if he can win, it'd be great.